Ahoy, hoy, and welcome to Selfmade. Today we make a scope for airsoft, paintball, whatever, in combination with a laser pointer attached to your gun. He will be a juggernaut on the battlefield. So yeah, let's go and see how it's made. So that's what we got. Let's see what we can do with it. So that's all we need. Just rip off the rest. This is for the adjustment of the front lens over this tiny arm right here. So yeah, we just spray paint it, make it look a bit cooler. So you have to turn it all the way down till the gap is closed. And then you can spray paint. And we will just put a bit of tape on the wheel and of course on the lenses to make sure we don't spray paint them. That would be not too good. So yeah, let's tape it. So now you just cut off a bit of the overlapping tape, because it would shadow, cast a shadow on the so-called shadow on the body, to make sure the paint gets everywhere we want it to be. Yeah, same for the other side, and then we are kind of done. Before we spray paint, I totally forgot. We don't need this second holder, so we'll just saw it off and then spray paint. Yeah. Bam, that was fast. Not even a second. And yeah, it's cheap plastic, so tiny black bits everywhere. And now it looks a bit better. Now it's ready for paint. So for the top cover, I will just cut open, this way, cut it in half, and then cut out the contours for the new cover. If you don't have aluminum tubings, you can just use whatever you have, even cardboard, just bend it. Just noticed my tubing is too small, and the inner diameter is too small for the rubber noopsie here. So yeah, off with his head, and then looks like a scope already. And after spray painting, looks a lot cooler, by the way. The fun part: peeling off the tape. And before I forget to tell you, the first thing you have to do after spray painting is done, moving the wheel to make sure the gap don't dry and seals off, so you can't move it. Or if it rips apart, you will have ugly tears. So yeah, but it looks good. We just continue and a drop of glue, and it's almost done. So to make sure we can mount our little scope, we need a foot. You can cut it out of square tubing, or just L-shaped profile of aluminum, or just bend one over the edge of your table and cut out whatever you need. For our little scope here, we need to cut out a bit to make sure the wheel does not hit it. And yeah, after that, you just put a screw in here and in here. Not in here, because that's the moving part, for the adjustment. And yeah, let's go for it. One of the cooler features is, if you have a binocular like this, you can use it for adjusting the height of the scope, which is kind of neat. And yeah, again, works better than expected. Just great. So here it is. I like the contrast of the aluminum, so I didn't paint it. Two screws and nuts on the other side. And yeah, as you can see, the wheel is still smooth. Gap between wheel and the foot. Yeah, it looks better than I expected. And yeah, like it, share it. Sub me if you like. Not sure what's up next time, but I'll make sure it's something cool. And I'll see you later.